To be among the living. Praise adoption in the name of Jesus. The title of this sermon, The Helper of the Helpless and the Defender of the Defenseless. The Helper of the Helpless, the Defender of the Defenseless. I know without an out of doubt in my mind, the Lord will help somebody in the name of Jesus. The Lord will help somebody in the name of Jesus. And will defend somebody in the name of Jesus. If you are the one, praise the name of the Lord sometimes.
Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now, There is in Jerusalem by the sheep gates a pool, which is called in Hebrew Bethesda, having 5 porches. In this lay a great multitude of sick people, blind, lame, paralyzed, waiting for the moving of the water. For an angel went down at a certain time into the pool and stirred up the water. Then whoever stepped in first after the stirring of the water was made well of whatever disease he had. An infirmity. Now, that's verse 5. Now, a certain man was there who had an infirmity 38 years. A certain man was there. He had infirmity. The type of infirmity the Bible didn't specify, but said he had an infirmity for 38 years. When Jesus saw him lying here and knew that he already had been in that condition a long time, he said to him, "Do you want to be made well?" The sick man answered him, "Sir, I have no man to put me into the pool when the water is stirred up. But when I am coming, another stands down before me." And Jesus said to him, "Rise, take up your bed and walk." Rise, take up your bed and walk. Like I said earlier, that is the spirit. There are people with different infirmities, with different diseases. But this particular man, he had infirmity. Probably the infirmity he had was maybe he was lame or he was paralyzed in his own body, not part of the body, but he can talk. I mean, he could talk. And when Jesus asked him, "Do you want to be made whole?" That's the question. It's either yes or no question. Like Pastor would say, he said, Africans, when they go to the embassy, they ask them, "How many children do you have?" It's either 4 or 5. They might say, "When I was in secondary school, I had somebody proposed me. I have one daughter. And when I come back, I have another food for that man." The question is, how many children do you have? I have 4. I have 5. That's it. Do you want to be made whole? That's the question. Do you want to be made whole? Yes or no? So this man started talking, when nobody to put me in some sort of agent, when the agent comes, nobody. That is not the question. Do you want to be made whole? Yes or no question. Before when I did my study, they said there were 5 porches. There was a pool that had 5 porches. You know, 5 is a number of grace. And now when I was doing my study, I discovered that Bethesda means house of mercy. House of mercy. You know, this is the house of mercy. This is the house of mercy. And as you have come, you will receive the mercy of the Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ. Single out that man, the Lord God Almighty, as you have come to his presence today,
We seek God for miracle in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus Christ singled that man out. He didn't go to other people, but he went to that man and they asked him, "Did you want to be made whole?" And what happened? He was made whole. The man was made whole. Now, who is the helper of the helpless? And who is the defender of the defenses? Let's flip up to Psalm 121. 1 to 2. Psalm 121. If you are here, please. Psalm 121.
I will lift up my eyes unto the hill. From whence my help comes from? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I will lift up my eyes unto the hills. From where cometh my help? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. Psalm 46, verse 1. Psalm 46, verse 1.
God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble.
God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Like I used to tell you, as a Christian, yes, trouble will come, but the helper of the helpless will help you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The helper of the helpless will help me in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God is our refuge and our strength, a very present help in trouble. Isaiah chapter 41, 10 to 14. Isaiah chapter 41.
Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with my right hand of righteousness.
Amen.
Behold, all they who are increased against me shall be ashamed.
Amen.
And confounded.
Amen.
They shall be as nothing.
Amen.
And they that strive with me shall be perished.
Amen.
Thou shalt seek them and shall not find them.
Amen.
Even them that contended with thee, they were war against thee, thou shalt be as nothing.
Amen.
And as a thing of naught.
Amen.
For I, the Lord thy God, will hold thee with thy right hand.
Amen.
Say unto thee, fear not, I will help thee.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He said, fear not, for I am with you. That is God talking. Fear not, because the thing of fear will come. But it's warning you ahead of time. It's warning you ahead of time. Fear not, I am with you. The Bible is coming to those who are really giving their lives to Christ. When that's it, the Bible is talking about those who have surrendered on to Christ. Because he knows that things of fear will come, but he's telling his people, fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you.
Amen.
I will uphold you.
Amen.
With my right hand of righteousness. Behold, all those who were incensed against you. Behold, all those who are incensed against you shall be ashamed.
Amen.
And disgraced. They shall be as
nothing. Amen.
And those who strive with you shall perish.
Amen.
Those who strive with you shall perish.
Amen.
Up to Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 39. Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 39. The Bible says, God gives life and it takes life. He can give and can give and can open this. Deuteronomy 32, verse 39.
See now that I am he, and there is no God with me. I kill and I make alive. I wound and I heal. Neither is there any that can deliver out of my hand.
Praise the Lord. So see now that I am he. And there is no God. There is no God beside him. I like that expression. There is no God beside him. I kill and I make alive. I wound and heal. That is God. That is what I said. And those who dwell with you shall perish.
Amen.
Those who dwell with your children shall perish.
Amen.
Those who dwell with your husband shall perish.
Amen.
Those who dwell with me shall perish.
Amen.
Those who dwell with my husband shall perish. The will of God. And I thank God for the Sunday school teacher in the believer's class. You want to know the will of God? You have to know the word of God. He said, Psalm 119, verse 105. He said, your word is a lamp unto my feet and a light. If you don't know the word of God, it is the word of God. I'm telling you all the time. It's more than coming to the house of God to die. The word of God shall abide in you. That is how you can know the will of God for your life. Going to the word of God, going to prophets, going to fear, to know the will of God for yourself, for your life, you are merely deceiving yourself. The will of God for your life is in the word of God. Go to the word of God, study the word of God, and the Lord will show you his will for your life. Verse 12. He said, you shall seek them and not find them. Those who contend with you, those who war against you, shall be as nothing. And as a non-existent thing. For I am the Lord your God. Will uphold your right hand. Say to you, fear not, I will help you. God is telling somebody here that he will help you.
Amen.
He said he will help you.
Amen.
He said he will help you.
Amen.
He is God. He's not a man that he will lie. He said he will help you.
Amen.
No matter what I went through, the Lord will help you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. He said, fear not. You of Jacob, you men of Israel, I will help you, says the Lord, and your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. He said he will help you. From the main text that I gave you, that John chapter 5, verse 1 through 8, that verse 3, I said, those people, they needed help, 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 and they went to the pool of mercy. They went to the pool of mercy. And that man that had a long-term problem received a healing. He received help because the man was helpless. Nobody to put him where the angel came to steal the water. Nobody to put him there. He was helpless. But the helper of the helpless showed up. As you are listening to the word of God, the helper of the helpless will help you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He will help you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He will help me in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He will help us in the name of Jesus. In this test, he said there was a group that had five porches. And I said, five is the number of Christ. The Lord will reach out unto you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord will reach out to me in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Mark chapter 5, verse 1 to 20. Mark chapter 5.
Then they came to the other side of the sea,
and the company of the gathering, and he came, and when he came come out of the boat, immediately there men came out of the tomb, a man with an unclean spirit, who had his dwelling among the tomb, and no one would bind him, not even with chain, because he had often been bound with shackles and chains, and the chains had been pulled apart by him, and the shackles broken in pieces, neither could anyone take him. And always, night and day, he was in the mountain and the tomb, crying out and cutting himself with stone. When he saw Jesus afar, he ran and worshipped him. And he cried out with a loud voice and said, "What have I done to you, Jesus, Son of Most High God? I implore you by your God that you do not torment me." For he said to him, "Come out of the man of good spirit." Then he asked him, "What is your name?" And he answered, saying, "My name is Legion, for we are many." And he begged him earnestly that he would not send him out of the country. Now
a large herd of swine was feeding there near the mountain. So all the demons begged him, saying, "Send us to the swine, that we may enter them." And at once Jesus gave them permission. Then the unclean spirit went out and entered the swine. There were very 2,000 who had put the herd man violently down itself into the sea and drowned in the sea. So those who fed the swine fled,
and they took it
in the city and in the country,
and they went out to see what it was at happened. Then they came to Jesus and saw that one who had been demon possessed and had been legion, sitting and clothed and in the right mind, and they were afraid. And those who saw him told them what is happened to him, who had been demon possessed and about the swine. Then they began to plead with him to depart from the region. And when he got into the boat, he who had been possessed begged him that he might be with him. However, Jesus did not permit him, but he said to him, "Go home to your friend and tell them what great things the Lord has done for you and how he has had compassion on him." And he departed and began to proclaim in Decapolis all that Jesus had done for him and all manhood. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'm very sure scholars of the Bible, you know the story of this man, the madman of Gadara. The madman of Gadara. Jesus told his disciples, he said, "Let us cross over to the other side," that is to the other side of the sea. And as they did, as Jesus stepped out of the boat, this madman was coming to Jesus Christ. You know, the Bible says, "The Lord orders the steps of the righteous man." The Lord orders the steps of the righteous. This madman of Gadara, he said his madness was on the high side. He caught himself, did everything. They said he was living in the cemetery. He was living in the cemetery. No man could buy me. No man could tell me. Nobody. That means nobody could help me. But this Friday, the helper himself showed up. The helper of the helpless showed up. As the helper of the helpless will show up in your situation, will show up in the situation you are in. And when he saw me, the man that was insane, the Bible said, and he worshipped him. Verse 6. And when he saw Jesus from afar, he ran and he worshipped him. That is why I am very sorry for some people. They come at the tail end of the service. Sometimes some people, they come at the tail end of the praise and worship. This madman, the man that was insane, he worshiped Jesus Christ. When it's time to worship, it's not the time for you to be looking here and there. We are worshiping the Most High God. We are worshiping the King of Kings. We are worshiping the Lord of Lords. We are worshiping the Lord who can kill and who can make alive. We are worshiping the helper of the helpless. We are worshiping the defender of the defenseless. That is the person we are worshiping. When it is time to worship God, don't let anything distract you. The man saw Jesus and he worshiped him. This man, he had a lot of legion, famous in him. Nobody, because people that were trying to buy him were trying to help him. But they couldn't help him. What does this teach us? That means there are some things, some problems. They are spiritual. There are some problems that are spiritual. So anything that is spiritual, you do it with spiritual. Anything that is physical, you deal with it with physical. Not only with physical, but you add spiritual to it. Because the Bible says this man had legion of demons. The X-ray they cannot show demons. If you do all the X-ray you can, the X-ray or whatever, or MRI, nothing can show demons. But when a problem is caused by demons, that is spiritual. That is when you have to go to the Word of God. That is why you have to speak the Word of God. Because the Bible says God honors his word more than his name. And not to call the story short. This man, after the Lord Jesus Christ healed him, he came to his right senses. Verse 18. And when he got into the boat, he who had been demon possessed begged him that he might be with him. That is after he has received his healing. However, Jesus did not permit him, but said to him, "Go to your friends, tell them what great things the Lord has done for you, and how he had compassion on you." Do you know, this man has been destined to be an evangelist, to minister the word of God, to be follow the service of God. Don't follow me. Just come and tell people what he has done for you. So a lot of us, after Jesus Christ, have done us with. The way God asks to tell people about the goodness of God, that is part of our responsibilities. Somebody preached the word of God to you, and you heard it, and you accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. Now it is your turn to tell others about the goodness of God. We will not fail in our responsibility in the name of Jesus. We will not fail in our responsibility in the name of Jesus. Verse 20. And he departed and began to proclaim in Decapolis. That Decapolis sounds like Decapolis. And he departed and began to proclaim, that is, to tell people about the goodness of God and the jealousy. That is what he was doing. And he departed and began to proclaim in Decapolis all that Jesus had done for him, and all marveled concerning you. People will hear what the Lord has done for you, and they will be marveled in the name of Jesus. People will hear what the Lord has done for me, for my children, for my husband, for you, for every member of this ministry. And the Lord God Almighty, his name shall be praised, and people will marvel.
Amen.
Because that man, he thought by seeing the physicians That disease failed to be healed, but it didn't. It failed to consult God. It failed to take his problem to God. And what happened? It died. That will not be your portion in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That will not be your portion in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I'm trying to tell you, people that receive the help of God, that man with 38-year problem, he received help from the Lord. The man of Gadara, he received help from the Lord. What about Paul?
And what he did, he gave his life back
et le vin descend.
Any power that wants to kill your God, the Lord God, who is able to kill, will kill that in the name of Jesus.
He said all his possible best
so that the plan and purpose of God will not come to pass in his life. Every power from the pit of hell that wants to take your life before you manifest the glory of God, let the Lord Almighty who is able to kill you there in the name of Jesus. Let that be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Let that perish in the name of Jesus.
Daniel chapter 3 verse 14 through 29.
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. I'm talking about those who God defended. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Because they refused to worship their gods, to worship idols, to bow down before the God. They said, okay, what we are going to do, we are going to throw you into where? Into the burning fiery furnace, which they did. But the helper, they were helpless. The helper of the helpless, the defender of the defenses, showed up. And what happened? They were newborns. Because God Himself defended them. God Himself defended them. So, because they made up their mind to honor God, and God honored them by standing for them, by defending them. As you honor God, God will defend you. As you honor God, God will help you. As you honor God, God will honor you. I will honor those who honor me, and those who despise me, I will lightly esteem. It's in the word of God. If you honor God, He will honor you. If you honor God, He will help you. If you honor God, He will defend you. If you honor God, He will stand for you. If you honor God, He will fight your battle. In the name of Jesus. Shall we stand up and pray? Shall we stand up? We're going to pray.
When the prayer is going on, because I know some people, they will stand here as an invigilator. You know what an invigilator does? When the students are writing their exam, something that will make them go to a higher level, the invigilator will be looking. So they have some prayer. When they ask you to open your mouth and pray, pray! Don't be an invigilator. Don't be worse. Don't be an invigilator. Pray! Pray! Open your mouth and pray. And the house of prayer, even the person living the prayer, is praying for her life. So the Christ, the instrumentalists, the ministers, the ushers, when I say pray for yourself, don't be distracted. Don't let anybody distract you. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Please speak in the house of God. Because God showed me something. I wasn't sleeping. Somebody, it was like a service like this. Somebody sat here
and cover his face with a hat.
I will tell you, if you have come here to bring you, I advise you to stop. If you don't stop, you will die. To the house of God, to pray unto God, to seek help, because we are here, every one of us, we need help. We need help. And God Almighty will help us in the name of Jesus. And if you have come here to cause wahala, if you have come here to do evil, if you have come here to walk against the children of God, we will turn to one person. I'm telling you the truth and nothing but the truth. I'm telling you now, repent. This is the house of the Lord. We are not here to pray or to play. We are not here to play. We are here to serve God We are here to pray unto him. We are here for God to help us because we need his help. We need his help. We need him. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It's just a warning. So, I ask you, I'm telling you to repent. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So, we are going to pray.
That Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 39. Deuteronomy
chapter 32, verse 39. The prayer has to be based on that text. Deuteronomy 32, verse 39. Can you put the script, please? Okay. 32. Oh, Payani, are you not there? Now, see that. I am he, and there is no God beside me. I kill, and I make alive. I kill, and I make alive. I kill, and I make alive. I wound, and I heal. Nor is there any who can deliver from my hand. That is God himself. He said, he can heal, he can make alive, he can move, and he can heal. So we are going to pray that every power that has been put in place to afflict my body, soul, and spirit, because